I'm just on my way now. Man, 40 years! 40 years! What a place you live in! Well, right in the middle of the city! Let's get a cup of tea. Oh, man. Hey, did you take those photos?
Yeah.
God, they're good. Yeah, well, they're great photographs. Do you live here on your own, Nev?
Yeah, coming.
Oh, yeah, well, this is nice.
Do you live around this,
man? Oh, no, man. I've come specially to see you. Yeah, I've been doing a lot of moving recently. You know. Oh, nice here.
Biscuits.
Nev, don't worry about biscuits of my kind.
What are you doing? Get away from the window.
Sorry about that, Spud. I'm not used to having visitors around here. I didn't expect you to walk through the door.
Nev, so good to see you, man. You haven't changed a bit.
I got fat.
I don't think it's that you're fat. Only thing that has really changed about you is your hair. It makes you look a bit more depressed the way it is now. Do you remember how it used to be? Rod Stewart? That was you. Rod Stewart, the cockatoo haircut. That's the only thing that's different about you, man. Wow, man.
Mental 40 years, God.
Strange, like, just kind of getting older, you know, how certain things come back to haunt you. Like, that night on the marsh. The night we buried the skull, you know it. That's been troubling me a lot recently. You know, that's what I've come to see you about, Nev. The skull.
Just leave it where it is. What does it matter?
Can't leave it there. It needs to go back.
It's cursed.
I'm never going to feel at peace otherwise. I don't know about you. Never. Look, you don't need to be involved. I just want you to know that that's what I'm going to do. Yeah? Just confirm the coordinates. 7 east by 26 north. That was it, wasn't it?
Yeah, 26 north. That's right, yeah.
You know, I went back there. Skull's not there. Nev, did you take it? Nev! Nev! Did you take it? Nev! Tell me!
Taking me.
Nev, I've been patient. I've been very patient. I need to know where the skull is. I need to know now, Nev.
You know it's cursed.
Of course I know it's cursed. I've been hunted by it for 40 years. That's why we need to lay it to rest.
I took it back.
You took it back where?
I took it back to the church.
Which church?
The one we took it from.
Where is it?
It's not far from here.
Take me there. You owe me.
Can we get a cab?
I walk everywhere.
What about a bus?
Walk everywhere. A bit of walking would do you no harm. As you said yourself, you're getting fat.
Thank you. can't believe you can't remember where the church is.
Come on, Nev, it was 40 years ago in the middle of the night. I remember where we buried it, I remember that we made a solemn oath.
I was in a dark place.
Nev, have you ever heard of karma? You broke a solemn oath.
I don't understand. When I got back to the flat, my wife was gone.
I'm a surprise, mate.
You're happy now.
Happy? Oh, hey. Come here, Nev. I'm really sorry if I kind of got a bit uptight, you know what I mean? And, but we're here now, right? Let's just go. We'll get the skull, right? And we'll go back to your place. I'll buy a bottle of whiskey, right? I'll have a few drinks, you know. And then I'll just collect my gear and I'm out of your hair.
Didn't leave it in the crypt.
What?
I left it in a bag on the front pew.
Have you taken me all this way, Nev? To tell me? You told me that you'd...
Take me back where I left it.
Nev, that's not where we got it from! And you know that! You've taken me all this way, you bloody madman! Yeah? Look, I've told you, it's all right. There were complications, yeah. Look, I'm right in the middle of sorting it out now. Don't, please, just leave it with me. No, I don't need any more help. Just don't call me back. As soon as I've sorted it, I'll call you. Yeah, okay.
Hugh.
Nev.
Pleased to meet you, Nev. Would you like to come inside? Are you looking for a few moments contemplation with the boss, as it were? Well, as you can see, it's rather a quiet place. In fact, this might interest you. The church does have rather a colourful history. Under those very steps there, where the old crypt used to be, they say the skull of William Shakespeare is buried. Do you know the story? It's fascinating. There was this man called Chambers. He hired these two rather unsavoury characters. One was called Dyer, I think. Got them to go to the Holy Trinity Church in Stratford to dig up Shakespeare's grave. They removed the tomb lid, dug down, and after a while, Chambers was able to hold the skull of William Shakespeare in his hand. Well, he then took it to these people who were offering money. Nobody was interested. And he was reminded that whoever took the bones or the skull of Shakespeare would be cursed. Your friend and I have been talking about Shakespeare's skull.
Nev, did you mention your bag? Sorry, we came to find a bag. Nev left here years ago. I realise it's quite a slim chance, but do you have a lost property?
Well, I'm not the best person to talk to about that, but we do have a church warden, and we do have a cupboard which is stashed full of stuff. Here we are. Feel free to rummage around.
We've got it. Great.
So pleased you found what you were looking for.
Thank you, yeah.
Great to chat to you, Nev.
Cheers.
Oh, Nev. Remember what was written on Shakespeare's tomb. Blessed be he who spares these stones, and cursed be he who moves my bones. Bye for now.
Yeah. What did he have to say that for?
Gotta go back another way.
Why?
Just to be on the safe side.
But why?
Trust me.
You don't even know where you're going. Thank you.
Why did he say it?
Well, what did you tell him?
I didn't say anything. I never said a word.
Do you think he knows something?
It's just weird. He kept going on about a curse.
Nell, shall I go back and kill him? Only joking, Nev. Only joking.
What about 40 years ago?
What about it?
We had a buyer and he died a painful death. What about my wife?
What about your wife, man? Why do you keep bringing your wife into it? Am I bringing my family into this? Look, 40 years ago we were just kids, right? It was just a coincidence. Nothing to do with supernaturals, with spooks or curses. It was just a coincidence.
Why did he say it?
Nev! No, man. I don't know the way to your place.
Oh, I've got William Shakespeare in the bag. Oh, I've got William Shakespeare in the bag. He's wrapped up in a rag, and their face are turned to ag, cause I thought with Nev. Nev.
I don't want to touch it.
Oh, come on, Nev. Nev. Let's open it. Let's have a look.
I don't want to see.
Come on, Nev. Let's have a look. Let's see what it looks like. Eh?
Oh.
Leave me alone.
Here, oh, listen. Come on, Nev. Hey. Come on, man.
It's all right. It's all right. I'm only messing about. I'm only messing about. Don't worry about it. You calm down now.
Yeah.
Shall we have a look at it then?
Nev! Come on. Let's sit down for a minute. We just opened the bag.
Put the bag back on your back.
No,
you're not listening. Put it back on your...
No, look, all I'm saying... Nev!
Why do you do this? You're always freaking me out.
No, I'm not trying to freak you out, man. All I want to do is check. Look, we may have been mistaken. This may not be your bag.
Fucking put it back on your back! You're doing my fucking head in!
Oh.
You always do this! Oh, why? Oh, why?
Shh. Nev, please. Just, look, calm down. What's that sound? I'm sure I hear something. Oh, it's a message from Mr. Neville Dad.
You're
from...
doing my fucking head in! You're gonna make me go
from
fucking
Mr. William
mad!
Shakespeare. He says, open the bag!
Shut up, you old open the... fucking shit-ass!
No, you look...
Fuck off! Look. I'm telling you, stop it now! You're doing my head in!
I just want to see me, Willie!
Fuck off!
Just, no.
Why do you always do this to me?
No.
Listen, you fucking silly old fucking man.
No.
I'm fucking idiot! No. Fuck off!
Come on, have a little look at my willy.
Nev. Nev! Nev! Nev, come on! Nev! Come on, you dude! Come on, Tig! Where are you? Nev! Stop pissing about! Come on! Nev! Nev! Come on, man! Come on! Nev, come on! Stop me!
Nev.
Nev!
If hairs be wires, black wires grow from her head. That's nothing to do with me. If it wasn't for you, none of this would be happening to me. You don't know what I've had to put up with. It's not my fault. I've already taken it back once. Spud said he's going to take it back.
Don't threaten me, mate. Yeah, well, it's in my court. Look, if you don't want it, there's other people do. All right then, get the cash together. I'm coming in. Thought I'd lost you, Nev.
Where's the bag?
I left it in the woods, ditched it.
So you got rid of the skull?
It's got the skull here.
So the skull's safe? Give me the bag. Is that your shovel?
No.
Take it.
How did they do that? How did they get in and get out like that? They've taken everything. My guitar case. Nev!
Are you looking at me like I'm the curse? It's not you they're after, mate.
What? You say nothing a lot, don't you? Come on. Come on!
Where are you taking me?
Same place as you, where we should have taken it back the first time.
Nev, will you wait for us at the other side of the bridge? I'm just going to take a leak. What was that about? What was that about? You know what I'm talking about. It's 50k. Get it ready. Cash.
What's your problem? All I know is, 40 years ago, this wouldn't have happened. You wouldn't have trod on my foot and nicked the bag and just left me there. Some mate you are, isn't it, eh? We're supposed to be friends. Friends don't do things like that, do you understand? Get up.
No. Just a few more minutes.
I don't give a rat's arse about you. I can see right through your cunning little ploy. You're not nicking it again. 40 years ago, you talked me into nicking that skull. It's been nothing but trouble. That skull cost me my wife.
Jenny.
How do you know? 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 How do you know?
Talking. Nev. That beetle, it really speaks.
Yeah. I've known her for 13 years. Since my wife died. She's a good friend. She stopped me from going mad. And one day I woke up and the beetle was on Jenny's pillow looking at me. It freaked me out. But it said, don't be frightened. Don't worry. I'll get you through this. She was the Dark Lady.
Nev, I'm sorry I freaked you out earlier, but I know what happened to Jenny. I saw it when I looked at the skull.
But it warned me never to look into the skull.
Heaven Spud, 21st century, back lanes of England, with, in the bag, one of the most precious objects in the whole world. I mean, William Shakespeare is universal. What's that worth?
I don't know.
Nev, we're doing the right thing.
Yeah, of course we are.
We agreed that you wouldn't call me. Look, I have the skull. I I've had an opportunity to have it revalued by an expert. It's 100k cash and delivery, and I'm not...
Who are you talking to? It's dead. Who are you talking to, Spud? Who are you, Spud?
Thank you. Excuse me. My friend, myself, and we were just saying, you look very familiar. You sure you're from the TV? I was saying, I think you're singers. No, I'm in the music industry myself. Songwriter. Yeah, I wrote a really big hit in the 1980s. Number one in 26 countries. Let me tell you this. Do you know, to this day, that song is still the most played song in crematoriums all across South Korea. The dead love it. I was writing music. Famous. I knew my music. Oh, it's great, man, to be sitting here having a pint with you. It's like old times. You know, we work well together. We got off to a bit of a rough start. It was mainly down to me, Nev. My brain was everywhere, man. You know, we're a team. Always were. I was thinking, Nev, we should extend it. Set up in business together. All that you need is one unique idea, right? Something simple that can go mega, universal, make us a fortune.
Everyone's looking for one big idea.
Yeah, but we've got it. The talking beetle.